Hi, and welcome back to my wild fungi playlist series. Sorry. I don't know why I'm all scatterbrained today, but anyways, here is a nice wild edible mushroom here, and this one is known as the Flowery Blewit or Lepista irena. And this one here comes from a family of mushrooms, and I just wanted to say I found two of them already picked up here, so I think I have at least one other mushroom enthusiast around here in my area identifying mushrooms. That's pretty cool. Maybe they're checking out my videos, maybe not. So anyways, this one here comes from a group of mushrooms called bluets, not to be confused with bleats. So bluets always feature gills, as you can see here. They're often lighter color. They are usually edible for the most part. I think all of them may be edible. And they often have a lighter color and an almost slimy, wet appearance, but very smooth cap. So this one here, the Flowery Blewit, it's considered to be saprotrophic because it is actually decaying a buried log here. Even though it may look mycorrhizal, it is actually saprotrophic, probably decomposing a buried piece of wood here, which is sometimes the case with this. So a couple of other unique features about this mushroom: it has a faint flowery smell. That's why it has the name Flowery Blewit. It is often prominently white, especially when young, but becomes pale beige, as you can see here a little bit. And when it's moist, kind of like a day like today, it should be pinkish brown near the center of the cap. So this one here, you can see the pinkish brown, not so much near the center of the cap, but if I come over here and I flip this upside down here, that's a really good example of it. Pinkish brown right near the center. That one a little bit as well. Very common with the Flowery Blewit. And it's gonna have no partial veil around the stalk, so flip that one back, you can see no partial veil, not even on the young ones. That is a very key identifying feature. Also, the gills connect right to the stalk. So on some of them, you'll see that the gills almost have a little trench around the top here. So this one does not. This one connects right to the stalk. Another little minute detail that can help you identify this mushroom over other ones. And the last thing is the spore print will be creamy white, which you can almost see that in the gills here. So pretty cool. Get some nice shots of it. This is the Flowery Blewit, a edible mushroom. In fact, I haven't tried it. And I do recommend some caution if you're going to try this one, because it is claimed to be edible, although some people get relatively upset stomachs even when cooked well. So never consume this one raw, or any wild mushroom. In fact, always cook it up, and cook it up very well, especially if it's your first time. So another late, not really late summer, we're more early autumn, getting into middle of the autumn almost. So another autumn fall time mushroom for you guys here, and an edible one. So I hope you enjoyed, guys, and a little quick video for you with lots of information. Again, always check out that description. I'll have tons of info there for you. I did cover a lot in this one, but I can't cover everything, so I do recommend to read through the description. It's gonna have some really good info there for you as well. And other than that, I hope everybody's doing well. Take care, and we'll catch y'all soon.